Welcome to this video about myOrigins 3. I'm Paul Maier, I'm the Population Geneticist at FamilyTreeDNA. Today I'd like to give you an overview of the new myOrigins, as well as a couple of teasers about future updates. This is the first video I'm going to do in a series, so make sure you stay tuned for more. myOrigins 3 is the long-awaited update to myOrigins 2, and the update began in October of 2020. As of today, most of our customers have their new results. I should say that myOrigins is a feature included with our autosomal product called Family Finder. And in a minute, you'll see why I've included these colorful looking chromosomes in addition to a colorful map. We're an incredibly diverse species in terms of our population history. FamilyTreeDNA is an extremely science-oriented outfit, and the science of population genetics and ancient DNA continues to give us surprising twists to our journey. Our journey starts some 200,000 years ago, likely in East Africa, and has continued across the globe for 60,000 years. All the while, we've been mixing with archaic forms of humans, such as Neanderthals and Denisovans, splitting apart, merging back together, isolating onto islands and new continents, or by culture. And many populations we think of as pure are really themselves mixes of previous ancestral populations. For example, Native Americans are a mix of ancestral East Asian and the now extinct ancestral North Eurasian population from 25,000 years ago. Given that vast timescale of migrations, let me clarify what myOrigins is meant to reveal about your ancestry. There are three broad timelines with three corresponding products. Ancient origins, shown at the top, includes most of human history from 200,000 to about 2,000 years ago. Right now, it tells you your composition of three prehistoric European populations. In the future, we'd like to include hundreds of ancient pops from around the globe. myOrigins, the subject of this talk, roughly corresponds to the pre-Columbian era, so 2000 to about 500 years ago. And a new product that's still to be determined will cover ancestry within the last 500 years, so I may cover this in a future video. Again, myOrigins is included in our Family Finder autosomal product. Autosomal means that this is a genome-wide test for the totality of your DNA. So what will you get? Well, even in previous versions, you would get estimated percentages from populations around the world and a pretty looking map, kind of like this. You also get something called shared origins. If you and your match both opt in, you'll find out which populations you share. So let's look at the previous myOrigins 2 map here. Previously, if you bought a Family Finder kit, your map would include one or more of these 24 populations. You can see that most of the world is included, but there are many gaps, for example, there in West Asia, and also many populations are very general. In many cases, they span entire continents. So let's compare that to our new myOrigins 3 map. Are you ready? This is a staggering increase in population count, from 24 to 90, a threefold increase. This kind of granular look at your ancestry is really unparalleled in the major direct-to-consumer genetic testing market, and we're really excited to see people's new results. Let's break this down by continent. So in Africa, there's a 5x increase, 8 specific populations in West and Central Africa that are common in African Americans, and another 3 different groups of rainforest foragers who sometimes show up in trace amounts. We also have the full diversity of Semitic, Cushitic, Omotic, and Nilotic people in East Africa, as well as Southern African people and Khoisan foragers. In Asia and Oceania, there's over a 5.5x increase. That includes 9 populations in Central Asia and the Indian subcontinent, 6 populations in Siberia, 8 pops that were previously just called Northeast or Southeast Asia, and 7 pops that were newly added from island Southeast Asia, for example, Indonesia and the Philippines. Also included are Polynesia, Melanesia, and the Sahul region, including Australia and Papua New Guinea. I might be biased, but this is probably the best Native American panel available to date. It includes Inuit people, as well as North American Amerindian, several exciting Central American pops such as Mayan, and a good representation of South America. In Europe and the Middle East, where we previously had the best coverage, we're also expanding our pop count by over twofold. That includes several different Jewish groups such as Ashkenazi, Sephardic, Mizrahi, and Yemenite, and also we're giving more specific predictions for Europe, for example, Italian peninsula instead of simply Southeast Europe. Also, some new pops, such as three Caucasus populations. Now, at the beginning, I said something about colorful DNA. Aside from the 90 populations, we're also offering something called a chromosome painting. So instead of simply giving percentages, you'll also get a painting showing where every segment of your chromosomes originated, painted by a unique color. If you're 100% pure something like this person from Ghana, this may not tell you much new information. But the majority of people have some admixture in their family tree. Here's a man from Mozambique, and as you'd expect, he's mostly Southern African, but there's some Congo Basin and some East African influence as well in different shades of red and pink. Here's someone from Ethiopia, and again, as you'd expect, mostly Horn of Africa or East African pops, but some North African and some Arabian influence due to recent admixture between those two regions. If you're African American, you may well have 1 or 2% of Native American DNA. As before, you would have gotten maybe less than 1% summarized in your result. Now you can actually locate those segments, like this one shown here in darker pink. And this could help you identify and locate it for genealogical purposes. Some people have mixing much more recently in their genealogy. This person is Lebanese European, with a Lebanese mom and a Northwest European dad. And you can see every chromosome has orange and blue phased to the correct side. Now, this is already going to be the case for your results right now with Origins 3, but also there's something called triophasing that uses your parents' DNA to perfect your result. And this is a future update we hope to have soon. I mean, there are many interesting mixes of people. For example, this is someone with a Finnish dad and a Filipino mom, which I don't, what do you call that, a Filipino person? And there are mixes that go much farther back. So the Romani people originally are from North India, and you can see this person has about 6% Indian segments or from North India, and you can see in gray they're kind of scattered across their genome. Most Romani people have ancestry that involves the local populations, and this person is from Eastern Europe, so as you'd expect, they have a lot of East Europe or Slavic ancestry as well. Here's someone from the Sami population. The Sami people traditionally are semi-nomadic reindeer herders, and they live either in Scandinavia, Finland, or northwest Siberia. And you can see in pink and white, this person has many Siberian segments. What's really interesting here is that most of those segments are homozygous, meaning that if they have one copy, they have two in most cases. And this is because those segments of Siberian origin, they're pretty much fixed in the population. Everyone has them in the Sami population. So that's really cool to see this displayed in a painting. Here's someone who's Finnish but has a trace of South Chinese ancestry. So before they might have gotten a result that says less than 1% Southeast Asian, but here it says specifically South Chinese, and it shows you it's specifically on chromosome 11. This is Roberta Estes, who many of you might know from the famous blog DNA Explained. So she already knew about two of her Native American segments on chromosomes 1 and 2, but thanks to this new algorithm, she now knows she has a third one on chromosome 13. So this is really helpful and really cool to see. And of course, some people are just highly mixed from all sorts of continents. This person is from the Seychelles, and they have ancestry from Europe, from Asia, including Southeast Asia and island Southeast Asia, from Africa, which is close to the Seychelles, and as well in the Middle East. So this is just kind of a nice palette of different colors from around the world. Okay, so let's recap. What do you get with myOrigins 3? Well, you get 90 populations, which is the largest number for any major percentage test on the market today. You get chromosome painting, which shows you where those segments are in your genome. And also in the future, we hope to add some extra genealogical clues. Right now, we have Family Finder Matching, which provides a chromosome browser. In other words, shows you where you share segments with different relatives, such as fourth cousins, and the chromosome painting, which is offered now. So we hope to combine those two to help you leverage extra information. Imagine you have a fourth cousin, and you're not quite sure which of your lines you have in common with that person. Well, if the segment there is a Finnish segment, Perhaps you're only 25% Finnish, and that can really reduce the number of possible shared lines. That could be hugely powerful for genealogical research. So that's it for the overview of myOrigins 3. Again, in the future, we hope to introduce several updates, including trio phasing, genealogical clues. Also, we hope to integrate mitochondrial and Y-DNA haplogroups to further enhance your experience. So that's it for this video. Remember, this is part one in a series I'm going to do, so stay tuned for future videos on what our reference populations are, some of the methodology behind them, and also maybe a video about what populations are generally and how that influences your result and your expectations of them. So with that, I hope you enjoyed the video. Stay curious, and thanks for watching.